Hello guys, and welcome back to yet another episode from the BWO Patreon server. Today is day 12, and we've made a little bit of progress on the Assassin's Hideout. Let me get out of F1. Now, from the outside, I didn't change a whole lot. I changed the bridge. I think some minor changes about the walls, and I made it a bit beefier down in the below, because of course it has to rest on a foundation. Even though there's like there's like no chance you can get to me, but I don't like having creepers near my builds anyway. Yeah, I just made it a bit beefier, you know, give it more of something to rest on, even though it doesn't really matter that much. I've been doing a lot of digging. Useful chest again. I broke a pick, my unbreaking 3 efficiency 4 work pick. Now I've got an efficiency silk touch unbreaking pick, so. And it's also almost already broken by now. This is the entrance, the scenic view. It looks fairly different from what it did yesterday, I'd say. Definitely a lot cleaner. It feels like a lot more rewarding to come in here, and I was a bit scared that like I would, the feeling of entering this would be very underwhelming. But I'm quite happy about the place where it is now. Of course, I have a lot more room to expand. That's the advantage of working underground. In the main hall, I didn't change a lot. I made these arches here. I added some lights here. I think that's all I changed about the main hall, except then also the entrances to the sides. They're identical, they're mirrored. This is the hallway I've been doing the most work on today, and the front hallway. Just a little banner on every side. And then I've made like the, what do you call this? These little huts for like the assassins to rest while they're at the base. I would allow them to, you know, personalized a little bit, together with their hot buddies, to make it a bit more interesting than just this. Though I don't imagine they will be used a whole lot, but you know, it looks good. And more room to expand in these directions as well. Yeah, like I said, that's mirrored. And progress on this build. I've also done this hallway, and I'm quite, like I said, I'm quite happy with the feel you get now. Progress is really slow because you have to dig out everything you want to build. You have to dig out, and then you also probably have to dig out the walls and then rebuild them like in another texture. Up here I haven't finished yet, but I've been doing once again quite a lot of digging. Gravel of course also gets in your way. This is supposed to be, or I plan this to be, the dining area. Just put a couple of tables down, probably like in this direction, and then this is supposed to be the kitchen, which I'll it probably won't be that fancy, but you know, I can give it a little bit of a try. But I haven't really worked out too much for this room. This is basically where I started. Well, no, it was the big thing I was gonna do today, but I didn't feel like it would be much more than a big cobble room. Also because I was lacking some inspiration. Then I decided that I really need to do something about the hallway, so. Well, yeah, so I'm just looking at it so much because I'm really happy with how it looks now. Maybe put a couple more plants down or something, but I'm not sure if that's gonna add to the atmosphere we're looking for here. And then down here, there's a staircase to the basement, which I haven't finished at all yet. Basically, the plan is to have main hall, living quarters to the sides, dining hall and kitchen upstairs, and then an armory and maybe a prison downstairs, and I think that's all I need. Of course, later on I could add more residential area, or maybe a library would be kind of cool. It's the way, like, when I dig a lot and when I build, like, just the... Because I just build like the straight walls first, like I don't do any, of course, luckily the retexturing that Bubbles did helps us a little bit. I don't do any decorating basically. I just get the shape in first because, you know, I have to dig. I first have to dig the hallway, and then I have to replace all the stones. And then later I can come around and maybe replace a couple of these with like a cobble version of it. Just to, you know, make it a little bit more interesting and just what Beatups has done. Like, this is what I mean when I say some cobble to it. Yeah, and then after that, like, I just place blocks, break blocks, place blocks, break blocks, until I find something that works. Sometimes I do something random. Like these columns here, they started out as just measuring how much space I had, if I could divide it in units of three, which luckily I could. A bit lucky, I guess, because I didn't plan that. I would have found some way to make it work, but... yeah, and then just I made these arches, which are different from these arches. But I think it works out quite well. These are a bit square, but I'm decently happy with it. All in all, the build is very archy. But yeah, I think I've talked about this build for today enough. I've enchanted a couple of things, got some decent gear. You can see my levels are slightly lower than what they used to be. And then I have... I went to the Nether briefly to pick on some more glowstone. Which, the Nether is getting really... Like, the spawn area is getting really low on glowstone and such, but... Yeah, I guess that's what's always gonna happen. Someone at some point will probably have to make a witch farm for the glowstone to become a sustainable resource. But yeah, that's it for now, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.